And the winner of the $75,000 2012 Gordon E. Moore Award in the category of Medicine and Health Sciences.
That was the entire talk, bye. So we've been talking a lot about this thing called cancer, and it's really near and dear to all of us. But imagine a world without cancer. What if there was a sensor that was like a diabetes test strip that could detect cancer for less than 3 cents in 5 minutes? Imagine 168 times faster, over 26,000 times less expensive, and over 400 times more sensitive. Well, I created such a strip. And basically, I was motivated to do this because I had a close family member that passed due to pancreatic cancer. And it's a really devastating disease. It's a death sentence, basically. You can see that after 5 years, only 5.5% of people who are initially diagnosed will survive. And that is a staggering statistic. Why, as a society that is so technologically advanced, should this statistic be acceptable to us? So then I got really interested, and I started doing a bit of research. And what I found is that there are these certain proteins that are found in your blood at higher concentrations when you have pancreatic cancer. And I was looking at one called mesothelin. It's highly overexpressed by pancreatic cancer, and as well as the early stages, where if you can find it in those early stages, then it has close to 100% survival rate, rather than 5.5%. But also, a main problem with our current diagnostic test for pancreatic cancer, it's grossly inaccurate. It diagnoses, like, for example, inflammation of your pancreas. And that, to me, is unacceptable. A 70% sensitivity and less than that for specificity, meaning it gives tons of false positives and false negatives. And so then, there are these really cool things called carbon nanotubes. And what these are they're the superheroes of material science. They're these atom-thick tubes of carbon, and they have these fantastic properties, so I'm super interested in that. And then I began formulating an idea in an unlikely place, biology class. And we were learning about antibodies, which are basically locking key molecules that bind specifically to a certain protein. In this case, the cancer biomarker mesothelin. So then I had an idea. I was reading this paper in biology class, and I also knew about carbon nanotubes, and I knew about this protein mesothelin, and we were learning about antibodies. So it's kind of like a connect the dots puzzle where you form a giraffe, but in this case, it's like a sensor. And so here's the idea I came up with. You have a network of the single-walled carbon nanotubes and antibodies. So what happens is when you put a blood sample that contains that target protein in it on this network, that protein will go into the network and form a larger molecule with that antibody. And what this causes is an electrical change in the sensor. And I can actually measure this with a $50 ohm meter from Home Depot. And it's really like easy to produce. All you do is you create a uniform dispersion of these, like you mix it up kind of, with these carbon nanotubes and this antibody. And then you just dip the, like a piece of filter paper. It's really, really simple. And then you dry it and you do this 13 times. That's not that hard. And you just measure it with this $50 ohm meter. It requires less than a sixth of a drop of blood. So it's a tiny prick to your finger. And so what you have to do for detecting a disease such as pancreatic cancer, when a protein is overexpressed, you have to set a cutoff level. If it's above this, then it's at an abnormally high level. If it's below that, then it's kind of normal and you're okay. So I chose mine as 10 nanograms per ml. And nanogram is a tiny amount. Think of it as 1 billionth. So pretty small. So then essentially what I did is I had to test whether my sensor was actually working. And so I took about 100 patients who had pancreatic cancer ranging in its stage, and you can see they're all above this 20 nanograms. That's well above the 10 nanogram per ml cutoff. So I had 100% sensitivity. Then I had negative cancer samples, healthy patients, people who did not have pancreatic cancer, maybe some other condition. And those are all below 10 nanograms per ml. That means that's not giving any false positives or any false negatives. That means 100% accuracy in its diagnosis. And this has the potential to save thousands of lives, reshaping how we think of cancer diagnostics. But in addition to this, what happens is it's also, I found, it could look at how effective a chemotherapeutic treatment or regimen, as well as how effective your surgery is. You can see here that for each of the different chemotherapeutic drugs, I tested five on mouse models, they all have different levels of mesothelin. So it could effectively see how effective your cancer drug treatment is. So it could look at drug resistance, for example. And so with this, I've created a sensor that can detect pancreatic cancer. And it's very simple, it's very rapid, taking 5 minutes for 3 cents. It's non-invasive, it's sensitive, and selective. But in addition, compared to the current gold standard of pancreatic cancer detection, it's 168 times faster, over 26,000 times less expensive, and over 400 times more sensitive. And that's not actually including that you need specific practice and like university training in order to conduct that gold standard, as well as it requires these expensive bulky machines to read this thing called ELISA. Well, as mine, it's a $50 ohm meter from Home Depot. And then also the protein I'm detecting called mesothelin, it's overexpressed in both ovarian and lung cancer. So this sensor is a generic sensor for those two cancers, but also implications are that that certain protein is found in 40 different types of cancer. This sensor is detecting nearly every form of cancer. And this has limitless applications. What happens is you just change this antibody in the sensor, and you can detect anything, any protein. That means other forms of cancer, other diseases such as E. coli, rotavirus, salmonella, as well as HIV, AIDS, all these cancers and diseases that plague us. Thousands, millions, billions of lives can be saved with this technology. And then also, it can look at how effective a treatment is. So this will reshape how we think of medicine. We will now have a simple diabetic test strip that can detect your disease in 5 minutes for 3 cents, but also tell you how to optimally cure the disease and treat it. And so, oh, two slides are missing. Shoot. Well, my final conclusion, what I'm going to leave you with, is that I'm not the only one who can do this. Anyone can. It just took me 200 emails and a bunch of hard work to do it, but that's a different story. But you just have to ask yourself, imagine a world, or what if? And then you can become like me and hopefully have a very happy running up to a stage. Thank you.